Hey guys, alright, this is going to be a little quick tour of the Boreham Test Centre. So that's the car park out there. Let me zoom into that and I'm going to go up to that in a second. That's where you guys are going to enter, alright, and that's where you're going to exit as well. So this is the test centre. You're going to walk in here to get you signed up, alright. This is the entrance. It's actually a really nice sort of waiting room here, nice and chilled. And then that's my spot usually over there. Anyway, the examiners will come out from here. If you guys need the toilets, they do have toilets here. Not that you really need a tour of this stuff, but that's... There you go, bathroom facilities. All right, so examiners will come out like this. You guys will be out there waiting. And then they usually use this desk or one of those to sign up on. And then you should go for your test. So you'll start coming out from here. All right. And then you'll exit. And then I'll take a little quick walk up here. All right. Mindful of the road. There you go. So you're checking both sides there. Because it's usually actually quite busy. This is really quiet today. So that's why I thought I'd take the opportunity to quickly give you a quick tour of the car park. So really simple, loads of bays here. If it is this quiet, you can actually be taken here to or start here and do your maneuvers. They've got a little section here for candidates only. See that? So if you are coming up in your own car, then don't park in the rest of the car park. You're only allowed to park up to this little line here, and the rest of it up to there is all for the candidates. Everyone else is for the rest of the building anyway. There's other companies here, so don't park in other bays. Apart from that, you're going to start from here. The barrier automatically opens when you're exiting. It does not close on you, so don't fear that, because some students do fear that. And then that's it, your test will start. You'll be literally leaving from the barrier section there, okay? And then this part is quite busy, so you just make sure you're checking both sides before you leave, all right? Pretty straightforward, and that's about it, really. Hey guys, right, 917 Boreham Wood, and what a great drive actually. It's funny because this student has driven before abroad, but that break from driving for quite a while. So when you're driving abroad certain countries, you're going to be driving on the left hand side, so coming over here and driving on the right hand side can be a little bit of an issue, more so with just the challenges of being a bit too close to the left. So I had a bad feeling about that, but so we went over a few of the tight roads, tried to get them away from the sort of parked cars as much as possible, and then kind of just hope that they remember that. And to be honest, it was fantastic, you know, to change a habit of driving on a particular side, and then you know, completely new orientation. It is quite impressive, to be fair. So really good drive, overall impressed from the examiner, were really great as well. Just a few minors for actually getting close to the left hand side, but nothing drastic. And then one thing to bear in mind, partly halfway through the test, they were asked to pull up on the left hand side, as you do, and student pulled up a little bit close to a junction. They signaled just before one of the turnings, so that wasn't ideal, but it was okay. They went past it and then kind of just sort of clipped the curb, but nothing you know, too dangerous or nothing too bad, to be fair. Examiner was absolutely great, and just sort of said to the student, it's good that you actually progress a little bit further ahead, because had you stopped that little bit too early near the start of the junction, it would have been a, you know, a big problem. So just make sure whenever you're pulling up on the left, that you're not near junctions. There is a rule technically in the highway code that says you're meant to leave a 10 meter gap, but sometimes where the councils are, they allow bay parking right next to the start of a road. But anyway, but that's councils. But yeah, overall drive excellent. Lovely student, and yeah, just hope you guys learn from the route. I haven't even had a chance to look for it. I've just literally got home and just thought I'd just throw the video out, just so you guys, if you've got a test coming up, can learn from it.